Hello, in this video, I'll be talking about the increase in estrogen receptor positive breast cancer in women under 40. Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel. We put out new content all the time, often in response to your comments or questions on this very channel. So there are recent studies showing an increase in not just breast cancer, but actually all cancers in young people. In breast cancer, in the case of breast cancer, it appears to be that this increase is actually in the incidence of estrogen receptor positive breast cancer. In the past, we've talked about how triple negative breast cancers are more common the younger somebody is, but actually this recent increase over the last decade or so has been in hormone receptor positive breast cancers, which are associated with a better prognosis. Though, of course, no matter the prognosis, we don't want to see an increase in any sort of cancer, that goes without saying. We've always known that minoritized groups, in particular Native American populations and Black women and people who have an increase in stress and allostatic load in early life, are more likely to have breast cancer earlier on. It's really interesting in Black women, this is as long as we've been following statistics, are at a higher risk of breast cancer when they're younger, and then the risk goes down after the age of 40, so that in Black women, the risk of breast cancer in a more typical age group is lower than in white women. But overall, Black women do have a higher risk of more lethal types of breast cancer. It's really important to us at Yerbba to talk about equity and special populations, people who may not be included in public health campaigns and who are less likely to have access to high quality care. Diagnosed with breast cancer? Meet Yerbba, your guide to personalized treatment options. Each option is specifically tailored to the unique characteristics of your tumor. Sign up today at Yerbba.com to take control of your breast cancer journey. So what might be causing the increase in breast cancer in people under 40? I need to say off the bat that we don't actually know what's causing the increase. So everything I say is based on well-informed but still speculative hypotheses that have been put forward. As you probably know, breast cancer is caused by many things, and for half of the people with breast cancer, we can find no known risk factor. So we really don't know what causes breast cancer in general, so we also can't know what causes breast cancer to be increasing in people under 40. There are likely to be environmental factors, inherited factors, and other familial factors that aren't necessarily inherited, but that might be related to growing up in the same environment, having the same lifestyle. I want to be really clear about something. Lifestyle we talk about as individual choices, but it's important to know that diet is affected by where we live, access to healthy food, and how those foods are treated before they even come into the stores where we buy them. And other things like smoking and obesity are also related to neighborhood. Do you have safe places to play? Do you have safe places to exercise? We know that income is associated with the ability to exercise. If you're working two jobs because your jobs are low paying or you have employment insecurity, that's not really a lifestyle factor, and it's going to be really hard to work to exercise if you have to work 16 hours a day and you're working during the night and sleeping during the day. So I just want to be crystal clear that a lot of things we talk about as behavioral are actually associated with the neighborhood that you grew up in, where your parents grew up, where you're living now. And a lot of that has to do with historical injustices that are not individual people's fault. So I want to be really clear that we are not blaming a person for having cancer. And I'd also encourage you, if you're watching this, to not think, oh, this person did that and that's why she has breast or any other cancer. I hope that makes sense. If it doesn't, put a comment below and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. So we know things like higher body weight is associated with a higher likelihood of breast cancer. We know that alcohol intake is associated with a higher likelihood of breast cancer. Long-term use of oral contraceptives that are hormonal may also increase the risk of breast cancer, but each of these things increase the risk by a very small amount. We can't say, oh, that explains all of it. Other things that I am concerned about are increased exposure to plastics. You know, we all carry around plastic water bottles. We carry everything. Everything we eat is in plastic, and it's really hard to escape plastic. Our buying choices are also forced upon us by the plastic industry and other companies that make chemicals. The environmental protections being rolled back worldwide and in the United States are going to increase our exposure to chemicals. Companies that make plastics and other man-made chemicals, not having regulations imposed upon them, are a real risk. And not just in terms of breast, but other cancers and other health conditions like respiratory and cardiac and neurologic conditions. Back to breast cancer at an early age. Another thing that's really intriguing is the microbiome. This is a fascinating field of study that's just emerging. Our bodies contain bacteria, and having more and different types of bacteria in the body is actually associated with greater health. So being exposed to environments outside our own and having more what's called microbiome diversity is better for our bodies. People who have colon cancer at a young age appear to have less microbiome diversity. Some of that is due to residential segregation and lack of opportunities, and some of it is due to our tendency to stay in our own neighborhoods and not to get out and about as much. The microbiome, even though our gut is not related to our breast necessarily, there's probably going to be in the next 5 to 10 years more and more evidence that the health of the microbiome and the diversity of the microbiome are associated with earlier onset of cancers. And again, not just breast cancer. Can I tell you that this is the case in your individual case? Absolutely not. We're not claiming to do that. Another thing that's intriguing is COVID exposure, not the vaccines. The vaccines are protective against COVID, and there is no evidence that COVID vaccines cause long-term harm in any way, including related to cancer. But COVID itself, because it's an inflammatory condition, and because we see inflammation related to cancer, it's possible that there's a link. We know during the pandemic, a lot of people weren't getting screened. But that's not the case in people under 40 because we don't recommend screening in people under 40. I'd like to take a moment to address the known risk factors in young women. The first is an inherited susceptibility from either parent, and if one is adopted or estranged from a family, you may not know about these, but in young women, especially with triple negative breast cancer, we do recommend genetic testing for all young people with breast cancer that's under the age of 40. If you have an inherited susceptibility, like a BRCA1 or BRCA2 mutation, that does increase the risk of breast cancer. There's also something called familial risk. Even in the absence of any known genetic susceptibility, having a strong family history of breast cancer can change screening recommendations. There are a few hormonal risk factors. Delaying childbearing or not having children can increase the risk really on a population level, not in a given person, but we know that the trend towards delayed childbearing may account for some of the breast cancer rise in younger women. Not having children increases the risk of breast cancer a little bit, but we would not say have a child to prevent yourself from breast cancer. So it's important to know about these risk factors, but not to think that's advice for how to manage it. We know that birth control is used for many, many years, especially if they were older forms of birth control, might increase the risk of breast cancer slightly, though the benefits of pregnancy prevention outweigh the possible increased risk of breast cancer. And then the last two things I want to mention, of course, is that breast density is actually a risk factor for breast cancer, and younger women have dense breasts. Now, even into our years and we're our 60s, 70s, and 80s, we can have higher breast density, and that is a risk factor for breast cancer regardless of the age, but that connection between younger age and breast density may contribute some to this increasing risk of breast cancer in younger women, although breast density does not appear to be environmentally related. The other thing is that younger women do not undergo regular breast cancer screening. Now, screening doesn't prevent or cause breast cancer, but it is worthwhile mentioning that younger women don't have this earlier detection, and there are good reasons for that that I'll cover in just a moment. In fact, we want to avoid radiating younger breast tissue, and we try to avoid doing tests that haven't yet been shown to improve outcome. Now, all that being said, if you have a family history of breast cancer or other risk factors, like radiation to the breast for another cancer when you were younger, or you have an inherited mutation like BRCA1 or BRCA2 or one of the many other genetic risk factors for breast cancer, that's a very different thing. But in the general population, we don't recommend screening. I've covered a lot of things in here. You might be wondering, what can I do? If you're wondering what you can do to improve your health, we recommend don't smoke, don't drink alcohol, stay active, exercise decreases inflammation, even if you don't lose weight. We recommend a balanced diet. If you're very young, it may be helpful to have organic foods, though that hasn't been shown. Once we're older, we've probably been exposed in the environment to all the sorts of things that we try to avoid with organic food. I would say get active in terms of environmental justice and environmental activism. Even if you already have a cancer and you can't prevent it in yourself, what about the younger people in our world? I'd love a comment or question if this has sparked a thought in you. And as always, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.